Hey guys, so welcome to the next episode of Which So-and-So Girls Would I Marry? For today's episode, we're covering Clannad and Clannad Afterstory. As before, we're pretending they're single. Fuko Ibuki. Absolutely not with her child form. With her older form? Still no. She's too childish. Kotomi Ichinose. She would be one interesting wife, no doubt about that. But I'm still saying yes. Koko Ibuki. Sure. She was a nice woman. Kyo Fujibayashi. She would be one hell of a wife. I can only imagine how many guys wish they could marry her. Yes. Mei Sunohara. If she was older, yes. Responsible and spunky. Misai Sagara. Only if I didn't have my allergies. I imagine she'd want us to keep the cat. Nagisa Furukawa. Absolutely. We clearly see how terrific she is as a wife. Rie Nishina. I'm not entirely sure what problems her grip issue would cause, but I'd say yes regardless. I could help do the things she couldn't. Ro Fujibayashi. Yes, sirree. Both sisters would be great to marry. Sanai Furukawa. Do I even need to say anything? Shino Okazaki. This will undoubtedly sound extremely shallow, but only if she was younger. Sugasaka. Maybe. She wasn't the nicest, given that she was defending Rie, but in all the wrong ways. Tomoyo Sakagami. Why would anyone say no to her? Ushio Okazaki. Make her an adult first before we talk. Yukine Miyazawa. Hell yes. And that ends this episode. Let me know in the comments section which Clannad and Clannad Afterstory girls you would marry, and stay tuned for the next episode. As always, please rate, comment, and subscribe, consider backing me on Patreon, and remember to stay chilled.